All right, we got a big one on the table. You can already tell by the size of the box. 1/16 scale, 55 Chevy Bel Air convertible from AMT. This is actually a 2-in-1 kit. You can build it as a stock vehicle, or you can build it as a modified. Look at the size of that plastic coming on out here to say hello to you folks. That plastic right there is more oil than OPEC pumps in a week. Huge slab for the chassis. There's my big mitt. I got big hands. Man, that is a biggin right there. That is some impressive parts. This is my first extra large scale plastic model kit. I've built RC kits before that are, of course, much larger. But this is my first big plastic kit sent to me by the Cool Cats at Round 2. We've got our exhaust in there. We've got that sweet front seat as a separate bench. I love that style. We've even got opening doors on this beauty. Look at the molding on there. We got our interior panels. Strong molding on both of those. So we're going to be doing this up in style. Look at the size of that thing. We'll push it over on the ruler here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. She's a foot long and 4 inches wide. This thing takes up some shelf space. Beautiful car. Moldings are nice and crisp. Easily be able to highlight those. They've got some optional drilled holes that are just underneath the plastic on the bottom where you can drill out to add emblems as a stocker or a custom piece. That is a huge slug of styrene. Even the hood has got half as much plastic in it as most 1/25th scale kits. What else can we throw out on the table? Let's throw some chrome out there. Let's throw some white walls. We're going to get to it all. There's a lot of stuff in here. That big, beautiful hood right there, and it is cut out if you want to do the custom version or if you want to put a scoop in it for the air cleaner, you've got that option. The massive chrome bumpers, almost as big as they are in a real car. We've got all kinds of trim rings. Even the steering wheel's got its own separate trim ring. Beautiful hubcaps on there. Tail light assemblies. We've got some lake pipes coming up there. Front bumper, rear bumper, hood ornaments, all giant slugs of plastic. Look at the engine block and transmission. Yes. Cylinder heads, there's the big steering wheel, wheel backs, pulley systems, manifolds, intake, even the beautiful Chevrolet valve covers with Chevrolet script on them. I'm running out of places to throw plastic as I show it. We've got super thin white wall plastic. If you want to white wall your tires or leave them stock, we'll see the tires in just a second here. Let's get some more plastic out. We got that. Let's get all the white styrene out. We got the big dashboard. Should be easy to detail that bad boy. We've got the stock wheels. Nice steelies on there. Good looking stuff. Here's the optional wheels. Air cleaner, valve cover, and our grill. That'll take a good amount of black paint to blackwash that. We've got our radiator, front suspension, horns. Even the horns are big. The horns are the size of the bigger air cleaners on a model truck. And our front suspension there. What else can we show you? We've got some crossover pipes, stock. We've got some hinge parts, pedals, brake parts, manifolds, air intake, scoop there, crossover pipe, depending on how we want to build it. We've got our nice frame cross member there. And we've got our boot for the convertible top. Of course, there is no hard top version in this kit. Convertible only, so you can see all the cool stuff inside. We've got that nice rear suspension and drivetrain, steering column, springs, inner hinges, and that big old battery. Let's push some tires out here. Before we're looking at those tires, they give you two nice sections, one thick, one thin, very flexible hose to simulate radiator hoses and spark plug wires. And of course, it's a big scale, so if you want to add some more parts to your kit, you can go right ahead and do so. Now we get 8 full 1/16 scale tires. We get these beautiful stock Firestones. That's what I'll be using. I want to do a stock version. I did a 55 Bel Air. You can watch that review in 1/25th scale, and I went custom on it with the wide tires and the centerline wheels. These are the tires you'd use with the center lines. They're nice and wide. They are Goodyear Rally GTs. Nice looking. What else we got over here? We got a great decal sheet for doing stock. We got dash cluster. I always appreciate that. And small emblems. nice license plates. We got it all on there in custom striping. And then we've got our clear parts, just the windshield, the side lights. The tail lights are molded in red and the side lights and headlights. So I'm going to get all this stuff washed off in simple green and we're going to start building this beauty. See you soon. A couple hours is all it takes actually to get to this. Just because it's big doesn't mean that there, you know, is a lot of complication to it. It's just larger, so there's more stuff and better detail and stronger detail. I'm going to be painting up the horns as black gloss. We'll be doing the cross pipe and the carryover pipe down to the muffler. That will be a silver metallic, of course. We're doing this as a new car, not beat up. The generator, because it is a generator, belt, the fan and everything will be all black like it would have been on the real ride. We've even got a hood prop. The manifolds will be done in a raw iron color or a steel color since they are new. We got those on the side. The differential and the springs will be done in a gloss black to counter the flat black of the bottom of the chassis. I did Google 55 Bel Air undercarriage, and the only ones I saw that were original were blackish, so they've either been repainted or whatever, but that was cool enough for me, so I'm going with that. This is the steering wheel assembly, super detailed, still needs that chrome trim ring, but this will be painted the interior color that I choose to go with, the whole thing, and then small details will be brought out. Check out that V8. Beautiful engine. Built it up mostly like I would any other engine. Carburetor, distributor, ignition coil attached, breather attached. Now, these are large enough that I could have painted them separately, but the reason I wanted to glue them in solidly and paint them separately is because I have to stick those little rubber lines to it. And I want to make sure that they're on there. They don't snap off. They are welded on there with the glue, unlike CA glue, which would just, you know, temporarily glue them on there. They'd snap off real easy. When I use regular model glue, the plastic bonds to the other pieces of plastic. We don't have to worry about it. Same with the starter. We got the water pump housing, our fuel pump, our breather. We've got those beautiful Chevrolet valve covers. So this will all get painted the Chevy orange or reddish. Depends on what your eyes see, but they say orange in the manual. So that works for me. That'll get painted up. And then we will attach our manifolds. And when we wire it, those are the holes where our spark plug wiring will go into. And then you can see the little nubs on the top where our radiator lines will plug into. The dashboard's ready to go. That will be painted interior color. The radiator surround and front wall of the engine compartment will be black based on every picture I've seen. That's our master cylinder. That'll go in separately. We can paint that as well. The wheels will be painted body color, and they are real nice. Of course, they're gigantic. They're nice and big. Should be easy to detail. Those will be getting those sweet hubcaps. The hood, I drilled the hole on the marked hole underneath for the hood ornament in advance so some paint gets inside there. And then I glued the hinges on right away so that I can hang onto the hood with my little clippers and get that painted as one large piece. The front seat is just ready to go. I just left enough tree on it. It's attached at the back. I left enough tree on it so that I can get my primer on it and start masking and painting. The air cleaner is all assembled. That will be a basic gloss black, nothing fancy underneath the hood. The exhaust, of course, will continue that silver theme. We've got it on the tree, so I can clip it on and paint it. The cross member, I also will do in gloss black to distract a little bit from the flat black of the chassis. The battery and the shocks will be done in a basic black, a basic General Motors, buy a million shocks, get one free. The boot will be done in a contrasting color to the body color. I'm not sure if I'll do that in a white or maybe an ivory possibly. That all depends. The body here is assembled. You can see I don't have the door hinges completely attached because I want to be able to take the door panels off and paint them and detail them separately. But you can see they already fit very well, just loosely hanging there. Once we get a couple coats of paint on them, then they'll actually hold when they're closed tight. We won't have any issues. But those will come off gently. And we can hang those on by their hinges, which really won't be seen. We can hang those on and get the panels painted and get the interior masked off and get that painted as well with both of the door panels. They fit very well. Didn't need to really work hard on getting those to fit. The body just pops right over the top. We'll shake that interior out of it. So there's really no work to do on the body except to insert that firewall insert, which isn't molded in, and that just gets glued in tightly. That's ready to get masked and painted. We'll prime the whole thing first, of course. Our interior is ready for primer. That's just one large tub. Our chassis, all I did was the front suspension on it. This is all going to get painted flat black, and I'll bring out the gas tank with some hand painting, but that'll all be painted flat black on there as one color. Then our differential, our drive shaft, and our cross member will be a gloss black, bringing that down with the engine and all the way through there. That'll give us some nice detail underneath. So I'm going to get everything to paint. I want you to come with me as always, and we'll see you over there. out of paint, ready to proceed with the build. You can see once the paint is on, the doors fit really nice. The hinges aren't even permanently attached, they're just lightly pushed in there. You can see that the doors fit tighter. There's a perfect size gap in there. We have to do all the chrome trim. The hood is on. She is a delicious looking car body, so that's going to be real nice to get finished. What that all needs done is a lot of chrome trim done. The windshield wipers, the vents need to be tinted in, and I decided that I'm going to leave the inner fenders the body color. That's just a personal choice. If someone rebuilt this car, that's their choice. If you're building a factory stock, the inner fenders and the radiator mount should all be the same color of black, but for my choice, I want to leave those inner fenders the body color. I think it's going to draw, it's going to look cooler with the engine in there and everything. So we've got the interior ready to go. We've got it in that light blue. We've got the door panels masked off and painted as before. We've got the back seat and package shelf and door panels painted. All I have to do is flock the flooring. What I'm gonna do for that is just spray on some diluted white glue and shake on some embossing powder in this turquoise and black, and that will make it look like carpet underneath. It's nothing, not a fancy procedure. You can get this stuff at Hobby Lobby. It's literally called embossing powder. You just shake it on over some loose white glue mixed with water, about half and half, and then we'll just sprinkle it on in the carpeted areas, and then it will actually look like carpet since this is a larger scale. The engine's ready to go. I have to hand pick out details. I have to wire it, and then I can stick it in the engine compartment. The chassis is ready to go. We just have to attach our drivetrain in the back and paint our gas tank. So there's a very good amount of work left to do. We have to detail the dashboard, which has a lot of decals on the decal sheet, thankfully. We have to put our hubcaps and our tires together and glue our white walls on. We have to get our cross member in. We have to get our exhaust in. So I'm going to keep working, and when I get ready to show you the interior, we'll be back for another update. Before I button up this ride, I want to get you a look at some stuff that won't be easy to see when you've got it all together. One, I've got the doors on and their hinges, so I'm just working on getting those aligned all right. We got the glass in. I've got the trim painted. I just masked it off and shot it with silver. That's great enough for me. I like the way it looks like that. So all I have to do on the body is all the final trim work, the grill, the headlights, the marker lights, the tail lights, stuff like that. Nothing real fancy, just a lot of the trim work and fancying up, and then work on some other areas like detailing a little bit of the firewall, but I won't get into too much of that. We've got the radiator all done. That's going to end up dropping in like so once the body's on the chassis and the engine is in, and then I can connect the water line from the engine to the radiator, upper and lower. Speaking of the engine, I've got the engine all wired up and installed in the engine bay. We've got the underbody all done. We got the fuel tank painted, we got the chassis done, we got the cross member, and those different colors do highlight it nicely. We got that cross pipe there, and it all fits very well. The lineup is quite nice. Wiring the engine, just follow the manual. I don't really worry about perfect firing order. I just run the rubber hose they give you to the specific places on the block where there's a hole drilled, glue it in, then run it up to the distributor and glue it in there. So all I have to do is attach the air cleaner to the engine, and we are all set on that. We're doing a nice shiny, like a full resto job. You know, someone put this together, painted it nicely and stuff. And it's not a perfect factory replica, but it's a nice new car for sitting on display. And the wiring makes it look even better. On the interior is all set. I use that embossing powder to emulate carpet inside. All I did was take some white glue spray adhesive, squirt it on the bottom, and then gently sprinkle the embossing powder, and that matches the tone of the interior quite nice with that turquoise and black flake. The dashboard is done. All that was I did was paint the dashboard with one color over black and then apply the decals provided, and that looks lovely. Same with the steering wheel. It's just painted. I painted the shift lever silver, left the tip the interior color, and then added the chrome trim ring that they provide, and in that scale everything looks lovely. So that's a beautiful interior. Got the wheels and tires done. Obviously going to use those white wall inserts. The white wall inserts do not glue on the outside of the tire. You have to slide the white wall insert over the wheel, then put your tire on, and it holds itself in place just with friction. Got our grill all done. That is ready to go and be mounted on. Got our battery done. once all that's installed, I can get that in place. Got our little air cleaner all painted up. That will go on top. Got the hubcaps black washed just to bring a little detail to the wheels. The rest of the stuff is all your chrome trim and emblems. That won't need a wash because there are small decals for it. So I have to put the interior into the chassis or into the body, glue that in place. They give these nice tabs that you glue on. Those tabs there that you glue onto the interior tub will then glue onto these under panels of the door. It glues right on the bottom, right on the bottom side of those on both sides. You can see the interior door panels are all done, matching that interior color and trim level. So we'll get that all together. I've got to put the hood ornament on, the hood, all that kind of fun little small trim stuff. Once we get the chassis, the interior, and the body all glued together, then I can put the wheels and tires on and get all that glued together and then start doing the trim work and the final little Bel Air decals. I will come back for a final soon. There she sits in front of you, the gorgeous 1/16 scale 55 Bel Air by AMT. It's an easier kit put together than I thought it would. I was actually intimidated by something of this scale. But as you can see, everything fits nice, works out nice, and comes out looking pretty cool. And it's got those operating doors. It's got the wired engine. It's got the plumbed engine. And everything looks real, real nice. I like the white wall tires and those hubcaps with a black wash on it. I did a go again and use the Mod Podge on all the clear parts, the windshield and the headlights. And I'm really starting to like that. It works out really well, like I showed you in the Dino Don review. I do like my color choices. That sea mist metallic pearl with that seaside interior, and then the turquoise flocked carpet looks awesome. This kit is going to be available very soon. There will be a link in the description where you can order it. Probably by the time this video comes out, it shouldn't be that far from the market if it's not on it already. There will be a slideshow at the end to show you how cool it looks out here in the sun. I decided to do a final out by my garden pond that I built a few years ago just because it's so lovely today, and a car this big and this nice really does need to be outside. It's over a foot long when built. It's got the operating doors, and I wanted a lot of light to shine down on it out here outside. Thanks for always for watching the workshop. We thank Round 2 for this review sample, and we will see you at the next review.